What's up, guys? Josh with Metal in Motion. Welcome back to the channel. So today's video is going to be kind of a niche, you know what I'm trying to say, kind of video, because not everybody's going to be working on this unit, but I want to get the video out there because I'm sure some person is having problems or having a hard time with this, and I just want to get the video out there so maybe it'll help. What are we working on? We are working on a John Deere three-wheeler with the four wheels in the back, so it's an AMT 600, and this does not have spark getting to the spark plug. And the issue is the coils, a lot of the parts on this are completely discontinued. And if you can find the old stock, they're stupid expensive. So this is the, what motor's in this? This has got the KF82D Kawasaki motor. And so, there's a gentleman that I seen on YouTube, is Royce Ardery. It's A-R-D-E-R-Y. I'll put a little description thing in the video, you'll see it. So he's the first one that I seen doing this method. And I know this looks like a total bird's nest mess here, but I just got it temporarily hooked up just to make sure that it works and to show you guys. I'm gonna go and clean this all up. But I wanna show you how I hooked it up. And so what we've got in behind the flywheel here, we've got a stator. And part of that stator is to charge the battery. And then we've got another part of the stator that will like charge up the ignition coil. And then we've got a little trigger coil that when the magnet passes the trigger coil, it tells the ignition coil when to fire the spark plug. So in order for this system to work, this is a DC, this is Chinese, but it's a DC, there's the box right here, kind of in the dark. DC CDI box, comes with the coil, a little bit of wiring here, it's $17. Is what I paid. So you have to have a working pickup. Now, if you don't have a working pickup, I'm sure there is a Chinese pickup that we could make work, but in this case, my pickup is working fine, the little trigger coil. And we need that because the trigger coil is gonna tell the CDI box when to fire the ignition coil. So, okay, how do we have this wired up? Well, it's a 12 volt CDI box, so we need 12 volts. In this case, when I turn the key on, I get 12 volts power from that switch, and it comes up to a black and red wire. 12 volts power with the key on, black and red wire. And we have a ground wire right next to it, and the ground wire is just going to be grounded to the engine with a little eyelet or something. So we've got a blue wire coming from the CDI box that goes to our white pickup coil, our trigger coil that's in behind the flywheel. And then we've got a green and a yellow and black, and that just simply goes up to the ignition coil, which I just have temporarily setting in here. So coming up behind the flywheel, we've got these wires here. So we've got the two yellow, that's for our charging of our battery. We're gonna reuse that. We're not gonna touch that at all. That stays connected. The brown and the red, that goes to our old ignition coil, and you can see I've just clipped those off. I'm gonna clip these off real nice and tape them, heat shrink them, whatever I gotta do. And then we got the white wire, which is our trigger coil, and that's the one that we're using. And that's it, that's how this works. Now there's some other wires that's dangling down here. I'm not gonna be using these, so we're just gonna do away with these. And the way this works is, yeah, 12 volts goes to the CDI box, the pickup tells the CDI when to fire the coil, and it happens. When you want to turn the engine off, you kill the 12 volts, which kills the CDI box, which kills the spark, which kills the engine. And it's that easy. It's that simple. It's taking an old engine and kind of using some of the components and making it a modern system, which is really cool, and for 17 bucks. And so let's see if we can get this to crank up. I've got some carb issues I gotta address. There you go, guys. And that's it. So I know there's not a lot of people probably out there working on these things, but I know somebody out there is gonna need some help, and this video is for them. So hope this helps. I'm Josh with Metal in Motion. We'll catch you guys next time.